Well, Thomas, there's this movie that I haven't seen, and it's not about the Avengers, but it's Avengement.
Right, right.
And is it like one of these mints that you buy, like a peppermint or an encouragement or, spearmint?
That sounds tasty.
It does, doesn't it?
I mean, you're kind of along the right track, but just missed a little bit.
All right.
So it's directed by Jesse B. Johnson. This is available on Netflix right now, and it was released back in May, but it's available on Netflix. And follows this guy, played by Scott Adkins, who escapes prison, he was on a prison, basically a prison transportation, and he escapes, and then decides to go out and take revenge or avengement on the guys that are the reason that he's in prison. And, you know, these guys, they're not good guys. There's some people that have kind of betrayed him, even including his own brother. And so he sets out and wants to show them everything that they've done wrong to him and how he feels about it.
Okay.
So
it's a revenge picture.
Exactly. Right. So imagine Tarantino's Reservoir Dogs, the narrative structure of that film is told in flashback. Most of it takes place in one room, but it's told in flashback. Then Guy Ritchie's Lock, Stock, and Two Smoking Barrels, where you have the English, takes place in Britain. You got the British setting, the heavy English dialect. I had to watch it with subtitles.
Really?
Yeah. Then you've got the John Wick franchise, the excellent fight choreography and stunt work, just brutal violence, just all that together. And that's basically what we have here. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Well, go ahead, Greg.
So you get the kids together and you've got an evening, right?
Oh, yeah. It's definitely a kid-friendly novel. It's a
the
hard,
Manson
it's
family,
hard R.
Manson.
Yeah.
So it's hard R.
Yeah. It's okay. It's 87 minutes long. It's perfectly paced. And it's compelling the entire time. And there's even a bit of emotion at the core of it. Some family emotion and really in almost character study in some ways. And, you know, talking about the brutal violence, it's not as bad as what you were talking about last week with a Rambo Last Blood.
Right.
It's not just to the point of, like, just overly, right. over
it's,
the top.
It's and, not gratuitous
yeah,
for
yeah,
the
exactly.
sake of being gratuitous.
Yeah, I mean, it feels real and it feels palpable. I mean, it's something like you would find in a John Wick movie.
Okay.
And it's really captivating and something that I'm really glad I stumbled across.
Well, good. So it really was one of these things you just kind of stumbled upon.
Yeah. Mr. Douglas Davidson had reviewed it earlier in the summer for his website, Elements of Madness.
Yeah.
And I saw the praise he was giving it, so I thought I'd check it out for myself, and I'm really glad I did.
Yeah, there's some great independent stuff out there. There's some great kind of under-the-radar things that, you know, the mainstream audiences don't get a chance to see, and that's, to me, the beauty of having something like a Netflix or an Amazon Prime, where you can get access to some of these things that may have had limited theatrical runs or just a indie festival run. And there's some good stuff out there.
Yeah.
Yeah. So what rating are you giving Avengement?
Solid B+.
Okay.
I mean, it's pretty light on the narrative, but really heavy, really well executed. So B+.
Okay, awesome. Thanks for sharing that, Thomas.
Yeah.
Well, let's talk.